XOXO, Gossip Girl. Pose. Good morrow and welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new, I'm not sure how you got here, but certainly I'm glad you came. And if you are new here, well, you're in for a treat. All right, if you enjoy chaotic, frenetic energy, and you also like collection videos, then you are in the right place, hun, because today is the day. I have another collection video for you. Today we're gonna be talking about primers. So I suggest you go ahead and subscribe, because then that away you will be alerted every time I do another collection video. All right, today. So I have primers, which I know a lot of people don't find very exciting, but I like primers for varying reasons. It's not even about like, oh, makeup sticking better or any of that. I think it depends on how I want my foundation to look, and using the right primer can really change that. Could I buy a bunch of moisturizers? Yes, but I feel like most of the time they're more expensive. So let's get started. First and foremost, I want to talk about the Revolution Liquid Power Pore Blurring Makeup Serum. I kind of despise this. Let's see if it'll focus. There we go. I have to do this because it keeps trying to focus on something in the background. I kind of despise this. It is hideous. I've tried using it multiple times. I just don't like it. It feels weird on the face. There's something strange about a liquid. It could just be me and my preferences, but like, look at how weird the dropper looks. Like, do y'all see it at all? Like, I don't love it. So you have to, and like, I had some difficulties at times, like getting the shit to get into. It feels like it just gets stuck. I think I'm actually gonna go ahead and throw this away. By the way, my collection videos are also sometimes part declutters. It's not always, but sometimes. This time for sure, the like little end gets full of product and gets stuck. It's very difficult to get product out. And it's just weird, like you've washed your face and all the good things, and then you put this wet shit on top of your face. And it didn't feel like it was doing anything. I didn't feel like it was priming. I didn't feel like it was blurring. Like and I felt like my makeup didn't look better on top of this. So we're actually gonna go ahead and get rid of this today. I hate it. I've tried it multiple times and I'm like, it's not doing anything. You may as well just get this one, which is the Wet n Wild Impossible Primer Base. I actually really like this one. It's quite nice. It is very, very thick. It's like a silicone-free primer, and they're like, it's a silicone-free primer that does everything. It really does. Like, I'm gonna show you my hand first. We're gonna try to put it right here and see. I'm gonna see if like moving this will like make it stop being weird focus shit, but here we go. I changed the angle. It does come out like kind of like a brick. I'm not gonna lie. It does not come out in the smoothest possible way. This is what it looks like on the hand. And then I'm gonna go ahead and just like rub it in. This feels nice on the skin too. I really like this primer. It feels good. It doesn't pill. It's not super expensive, but I will say this about it. I will pill a little bit if you are deeply moisturized, because I've run into that before. The other thing I'm going to say is if you don't want to have to repurchase a primer quite a bit, I would not recommend this one, but I still like it. Like, it's not the best thing in the world, but it's not the worst either. So that's that one. I also have Marc Jacobs. I have two Marc Jacobs primers. I have the Invisible, it's a perfecting coconut face primer. And then I also have the Blurring Coconut Face Primer. So these are them. So this one is gonna be more like lotion-y, I feel like. It's like a thinner consistency. Let me just show y'all shit. I'm like, show and tell time. This one's gonna feel like be a little bit more like a lotion, as you can see here. And then the Blurring is lotion-y, I guess, but they're both like, I don't know. I don't know how to explain it. This one's more silicone-y, that's what it is. So one is more lotion-y, one is more silicone-y. And you can kind of tell if you look at this, like what the little blurring properties are going to do. I love this concealer, this primer. I love this primer so much. It is fantastic. I especially like it in the summer because there's something about like how this goes on. It makes my makeup just look really nice. And then this one's gonna be, you know, typical lotiony primer, right? So my hands are gonna be so nice later. So anyway, but I really like both of them. If you don't like coconut, obviously, or you have a sensitivity to coconut, obviously these will not be for you, but I really enjoy them. What I find interesting is that they don't really smell a lot like coconut. Like, it's just, that's why I got them, is because I was like, they'll smell like coconut. They kind of don't, but both of them do a very good job of like making my skin look nice. In fact, right now I have on the Marc Jacobs Invisible. I have that on underneath here, and I just feel like it gives me just like this beautiful kind of glowy, like natural skin look, which I enjoy. But it's up to you, you know, it's on you, boo. Next, we're going to talk about, speaking of coconut kind of things, we're going to talk about the, let me grab this one, the HelloFab Coconut Skin Smoothie Priming Moisturizer. Absolutely love this one, because this one you can actually just go on ahead and wear. I don't know why it's not trying to focus for me today. Anyways, it's the lighting. It's my own fault. We're gonna move past it. I'm gonna put it back here so you can see it, and we'll move in closer. But this one is particularly lovely because I don't have to put on a moisturizer before. If I don't want to, I can just go ahead and use this as my primer and my moisturizer. I know some people don't use primer anyway and use moisturizer. I like to use both because for me, I have oily skin. It's very helpful sometimes for me to have something here to kind of like have a barrier between the oil and my face. But I really like this one. I love to have like hydrating primers for oily skin because I find that it helps with my sebum production. I've said this a lot of times, so I'm sorry if you have heard this before, but it helps with my sebum production. My face is less oily because of the hydration that's going on in my skin. And then when I'm out there in this hot ass Texas sun, it's not all coming off. This one does smell like coconut, and it feels really, really nice on the skin. Really nice. And then the next one that is also kind of smells of coconut is the Tarte Double Duty Base Tape. I really like this. I feel like people don't talk about this one enough. It's a really nice primer. It's hydrating. It feels good. You can actually see how much product you're using, like where you are in it. You know what I mean? Like, that's one of the things I do absolutely love. You can definitely see it. So you're like aware, like, oh, I'm running low, and you can get some more if you want more. The pump is always functional. Like, that's the other thing I like about it, is like the pump is always functional. Comes out like, you know, it's more of a lotiony primer. Hydrating, of course, which I love. So I have it right here, and then I'm just going to rub it. I have had this for a little bit, so I have like that little squirch from the front. the primer booger. Anyways, I'm sorry, that was disgusting. Let me move past that. But yeah, this is a really nice primer. It goes on very lovely. My makeup sits on top of it very nice. In fact, that primer and the coconut smoothie primer are the two that I use if I'm having any problems with a base product. I will use those two primers, and if it does not work underneath, like on top of those, then it's not gonna work, because those are my diehard day ones. Like, I will continue to use those primers forever. In fact, the Tarte Double Duty Base Tape and that HelloFab one are the ones that made me actually enjoy primers when I discovered, like, oh, it's the silicone. It's the silicone that can be problematic for me. So next up, we have the Becca Skin Love Brightening and Blur Primer. This one is infused with Glow Nectar. Obviously, Becca's going out of business, but I do like this primer a lot. It is very fragranced, though. I am not gonna lie. Like, this has a very perfumey scent to it, but it is a really nice primer. Makes my skin look glorious. And in fact, another thing that I like about this primer and the ones I mentioned before is, excuse me, if I just want to put my primer on, ooh, this is so nice. It's a little thicker, but it feels so good. But if I want to put these on and then put like a little bit of powder atop my face and then like live my best life, that's what I do. Instead of actually like putting on a foundation, I will just use a little powder, and it's just nice. I don't know what I'm showing you, but like, I listen, this is who I am as a person. But it's a very nice primer. It feels very good, but again, if you are sensitive to smell, that one is highly perfumed. Howsomever, its cousins are going to be the Flower Beauty In Your Prime Hydrating Primer, which if you're looking for a replacement for that, I would suggest this one is one of them. This primer is really nice as well. I can't remember, I just like punched myself in the nose with that. But I'm over here like priming my arm, y'all, for the things I do for the tube. But this is a really nice primer. Again, very moisturizing, very hydrating, feels good on the skin, looks like that. It's just like nice lotiony, not overly thick either. It's gonna go into the skin pretty easily. And one of the things that I also love primers for is if you do bright, colorful looks, having a primer is like a good friend, because any fallout, it's easier to take it off when I have my primer on. And I can kind of quickly like dot that out or use powder or whatever and get that off and then put on my face makeup and all of that good shit. But yeah, this one's really nice. Has a bit of a smell, but it's kind of a funky smell. It's like not a good smell, but it's not a bad smell. I find it kind of funky, but that's me. But yeah, I like this one a lot. It's very hydrating, very pretty, makes my skin look good. And the other cousin to the Becca is going to be the Prime and Fine Aquafresh Hydro Primer from Catrice. It's their Fresh It Up line. Like, this is so nice. It is like, it has no business being as good as it is, but it's such a nice primer. It's not too thick, feels good on the skin. There it is. Feels lovely on the skin, makes me a happy camper whenever I have it on, or a happy non-camper because I don't camp. But like, oh gosh. And it doesn't really have a smell. It could have a smell, but now my nose is like, smells? There's a lot of smells. I'm like, I know, sorry. But it's a nice primer. It goes on very easily. And I feel like when I put that on, my skin really does feel like fresh and hydrated. So I love that one so much. Now, we're gonna go into, this one is not my favorite. This one's from AOA Studios, which is the flagship brand of Shop Miss A. This primer, I don't like. I really don't like it. I keep trying. It's supposed to be a perfecting blur primer. I keep trying to like it, I just don't. I think it's because it's like, okay, let me just put it on this part of my arm. Let me see the, like a part that I can show you. It has glitter particles in it, and I feel like it's silicone-y. It just doesn't, I don't like it the way that it feels on my skin. And I feel like it tends to, let me see if you're getting a shot of that, okay. I also feel like it just tends to make my makeup slip and slide, which is something I don't love in a primer. And so I just don't, like, this isn't my favorite. I'm gonna try it a couple more times, but it's interesting because it feels like a gel when it goes on, and then it kind of dries down to like almost a little bit of a powdery consistency. So I'm gonna give this one more shot and we'll see from there. But like, I so far don't love it. I'm gonna try it again and see if maybe it was the foundation I had on top of it. Next we're gonna go ahead and talk about the BH Paradise Prime. It is a hydrating face primer. This one I would say is a good substitute if you do not want to be able to get the Marc Jacobs. This one will work in its place, the blurring coconut primer. This one has a little bit of a blur effect. It's quite lovely, feels good on the skin. A lot of times you're gonna notice that like blur effect primers will be more see-through or clear, and this one goes on, I'm putting it in this little circle here, and just really gives you like this very blurred, like my skin is, I don't have pores, I wasn't even born of this world kind of a look. So I really like that from BH Cosmetics. It's a lovely primer. The next one I want to talk about is the Milani Chill Out Soothing Primer. This one is quite lovely. It is, you know, it's not a bad deal. It's a nice primer. Now, it's not like you're going to write home about it, but it does feel good. I feel like it is a little bit scented, and let me just scorch some. I'm like rubbing it and scorching it. This one does have a little bit of a blurring effect as well. I forgot about that. And so I like this. It's silicone free for those of you who are wondering. Doesn't have any silicone in it. So this is what it looks like. And it's quite nice. Like, it goes on, and I'm loving how many companies finally figured out, like, a lot of us don't want silicone in our primers because it just kind of makes your makeup slide off of your face. You're like, thanks for this slippery ass face. Like, it's cute on YouTube and doing videos and for like looks, but it's not cute in your real everyday life. But I like this. It does have like a kind of a cooling sensation when you put it on, so prepare yourself for that. But I actually really like that one. On the fence, I have the Lancome La Base Pro. So many people talked about this a lot, and I just don't don't know how I feel about it currently. I've tried it a few times and I can't really decide if I like it or don't like it. And I think it just really depends on the foundation. I'm gonna try this with a couple more foundations, which you've probably already seen at this point. I have quite a few to choose from. So I'm gonna try this with a couple more foundations and see if I like it better then, and we'll come back on that. But it's just, it's clear, it's silicone-y. I don't know if it actually has silicone in it. I will put that right here if it does, but it's, like, it's all right. Like, I felt like this was everybody's go-to. That's why I bought it. I bought it during the Ulta 21 Days of Beauty, and I just got clowned. You know what I mean? I feel like I got clowned a little bit because everyone was like, oh, this is my holy grail base. And I'm like, am I doing it wrong? Probably. But next up, we have the Hourglass Veil Primer. And again, we're just going through my collection, so I'm not gonna like withhold things or whatever because of varying issues with the brands at this point in time. But I do wanna say that I used to like this significantly more than I currently like this because it has this weird blue cast and it's very strange. Like, do you see what I'm talking about? It has a weird blue cast and I can't figure out, is it the mineral that's done that? Like, I don't get it. I mean, it does go away, but like, kind of, but it just kind of leaves like a bit of a soft light blue on you. And so like, so I just found that very weird. It just leaves this like weird, you know what? I actually am gonna go ahead and get rid of it because it was a good primer, but the blue cast is something I cannot get past. So I'm gonna get rid of that one as well because I'm not here for it. I'm not living for it. I'm not living my best life with it. No thank you, have a good day. The next two are gonna be MAC Strobe Creams, which some people would say that they aren't primers. I would say that they can be primers and I often use them as such. So the MAC Strobe Cream, I have it, like I have a small little one that I received as like, I feel like I got it in like a beauty box. It's pink light. And then I also have gold light and they're just really nice. They are very, very moisturizing. They have a lot of like thickness and to the property of them. So I would be a little careful with these when you want to put them on. If you want to glow, glow. But I'm saying if you want to put foundation on top of it, like a matte foundation, which is what I like to do so that my matte foundation doesn't look so matte. Like this is, if you have matte foundations, I have a ton of hydrating primers. I would highly recommend grab you a hydrating primer. If you like, if you're not wearing your matte foundation just because it's too matte and you don't love that, hydrating primers will save the day. But like here it is. Ah! And then it has like a shimmer to it. So here's the gold base. I hope you're gonna be able to see this when I bring it up, but like it has a bit of a shimmer on it, like a little bit of a shine, gives you a little bit of glow. So again, this is great to use. Both of these are fantastic to be able to use if you have matte foundations that you're just trying to be like, I don't really love this, or even like a natural finish that you want to amp up. So that's what I use these for in my life. Next up and finally, we have the e.l.f. Luminous Matte Makeup Primer. I absolutely adore this primer. It's so nice. Such a nice primer. It is so moisturizing, and then like it gives me just like a little bit of a blur effect. Let me see if I can find a place to put this. It gives me a little bit of a blur effect, hydrates my skin. My skin looks lovely, but it's not overly done. So this is what it looks like. It's not overly done to where it's gross. It does have kind of a glue-like feel to it at first. Like it does, like that was off-putting for me at first. But once I saw how my makeup sat on top of it, I was like, never mind, bitch, get out. I love this so much. So yeah, here we go. That is it. These are my primers, y'all. We were actually able to go ahead. I'm like really excited because I was actually able to go ahead and declutter too while I did that. And this is kind of why I'm gonna, you know, continue to do collection videos, I feel like, because it helps me kind of go through and realize and remember like, oh, I don't like this and this is why I don't like it. Why didn't I pay attention to that before? So I'm feeling good about that. All right, yeah, I'm kind of a boss. If you enjoyed this video, please do me a favor, hit that thumbs up button and let me know down in the comments, what are your favorite primers? Are there ones that you think that I should try? Have you tried any of these? Did I help you to make any decisions? These will all be linked in the description box below and those will be affiliate links, which do earn me a commission. If that makes you uncomfortable, you don't have to use them. All right, we're really done now. And before I leave, Huge shout out to my patrons and spooky bays. Yeah. All right, you know the drill. It costs $0 to be kind, and it's so good for your soul. Because if you don't take care of it, I'm sure as hell coming for yours. There will be no bloopers, but there will be me frantically singing a song. Until next time, XOXO. Gotham girl.
First you die to get in again.
You're in for a treat.
Burning on, just like a match, you strike to incinerate.
And we're gonna try to put it like right.
And what's the worst you take for every heart you break?
I don't know why I did that. Okay, these are them. Wait.
When both our stars collide.
Next up, we have the Hourglass Ville.
So long and good.